Now we look at definite integrals. In all the previous videos, we were dealing with indefinite integrals. So for a definite integral, you need to make sure you have limits. So this is how the format of a definite integral looks like. It's very similar to the normal indefinite integral which we are used to, but it's just that this one has limits. So suppose if you have something like integral of 2x dx, this is very similar to the integral of 2x and you introduce some limits, say 2 and 5. So what you're gonna do here is you're gonna integrate 2x the normal way on how we learned, but then you substitute the limits. So let's see what we're talking about over here. Assume that we are supposed to integrate say 5x and your limits are 1 and 2. Another thing you need to make sure that in a definite integral, your b will always be greater than a. So therefore this is your b and this is a. So you need to make sure that that b will be greater than a. Hence you're able to solve a definite integral. So to solve this, just do it the normal way on how you learnt it. You have 5x, so you do 5x squared divided by 2. And then you put the brackets showing the limits, 2 and 1. It doesn't really matter where you put the limit. You can put it here or here. It doesn't really matter. Now is where you do the definite integration. You substitute this as x and then this as x. So this gives you 5 into 2 squared divided by 2 minus 5 into 1 squared divided by 2. I'm putting the brackets in order to make it clearer for you to show you which things we're subtracting. So you substitute this first because it's the greater one, and then you substitute this because it's the smaller one, and then you need to make sure that you subtract them. Once you are able to understand that, then just compute it. 2 squared is 4, 4 times 5 is 20, and 20 divided by 2 is 10, minus 1 times 1 is just 1, 1 times 5, 5 divided by 2, 5 over 2. So 10 minus 5 over 2, that's equal to 15 over 2. That's your answer. Here, you're not going to be putting any plus c. You don't put any plus c because you notice that here we are given the values. We are given the limits. B and a are the limits, and you need to make sure b is going to be greater than a. And then once you're able to notice that it's a definite integral, all you need to do is just integrate the normal way on how we learned it. And you just substitute the limits which we are given, and you need to make sure that the top one goes first minus the bottom one, and you get your answer. You can use this for any type of integration, any type of definite integration involving trigonometric functions or even exponential functions or just normal questions. So you need to make sure that you need to substitute the limits correctly and then you subtract in order to get an answer. So let's do this question. Integral of x squared plus 4x plus 3 with respect to x, but you're given limits as 5 and 10. So again, just do it the normal way on how we learned it. Integrate each term separately. So that gives you x cubed divided by 3 plus 4x squared divided by 2 plus 3x. Now I just want to simplify this to give you x cubed over 3 plus 2x squared plus 3x. Now you are integrating this, but as a definite integral. So you need to put the limits, 10 and 5. Again, just do the normal way on how we learned earlier. Substitute these things into the function. So that gives you 10 cubed divided by 3 plus 2 into 10 squared plus 3 into 10 minus 5 cubed over 3 plus 2 into 5 squared plus 3 into 5. So I use my calculator to solve this, and the value you get is 1370 divided by 3. So the answer to this is equal to 1370 divided by 3. Remember, the plus c won't be here because you were given limits. If we were not given limits, the answer would be the integral of this only, which is actually this plus c. So always take into account the limits also.